All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Bill Frain, the CEO of Liberty Defense. And Bill, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great, Steve. Thanks. How are you?
Good, good. Lots of stuff to talk about with you as we sort of dive into the company a little bit and also about your technology, HEXWAVE. We'll get to that in a second, but maybe give me a bit of background on Liberty Defense.
Yeah, so Liberty Defense, we were formed in about 2018, and we have a flagship product called HEXWAVE technology, which we've exclusively licensed out of MIT. And it's a walkthrough screening portal using radio frequency. And we do real-time 3D video rate imaging. And really what we're doing is we're detecting any type of threat, metallic, non-metallic, any type of anomaly that is on the body. And you're doing it as you kind of walk through the system. So it's a very, you know, safe technology, radio frequency, very similar to the body scanners that are used at the airports today in the US and in Canada. And so we've been in beta phase for the last, I'd say, 4 or 5 months, and we'll be looking to go for a commercialized product here in early 2023.
So Bill, are you looking at this to replace things that are currently in use or to enhance things that are currently in use?
It's probably a combination, Steve, in that, you know, we'll replace a lot of the metal detectors that are out there today because there's a gap in security, right? We're starting to see, even in the urban market, commercial market, as well as, you know, the aviation for employee screening, the fact that they want to look for more, right? Want to look for, you know, all types of threats that might be on the body or even in a distribution center that may be used for, you know, theft prevention. So really, again, looking for anomalies and threats that are on the body. So, you know, new applications as well as replacing some technology that's out there today.
So it can go to a lot of different sectors. It's not necessarily airports is just one thing, but it can go to a number of different sectors.
Absolutely. We've been trialing at religious, places of worship. We've been at a Major League Baseball stadium. We've been working with airlines, with airports, with, you know, Capitol buildings, Fortune 500 companies, you know, as employees start to come back to work. So, yeah, several different applications. And unfortunately, with, you know, the threats and events we've been seeing in the U.S., there's certainly a demand and need for this additional type of security.
So some of that beta testing actually going on right now at Pearson Airport in Toronto. And so explain to me why the beta testing part of it is so important and the data that you glean from that.
Yeah, and it's good for, you know, it's good for Liberty as well as it's good for Toronto Airport. Really, to, you know, for us, we're looking to see, you know, the operational performance of the system. You know, 100% availability is obviously, you know, crucial for customers, you know, especially as we're looking for this enhanced detection capability. So we're getting data on throughput capability, on detection performance, false alarm rate performance, you know, and again, the overall, you know, patron experience as people go through the system. And then, you know, Toronto, you know, they're looking for, you know, that added layer of security, as, you know, you kind of mentioned earlier, to be able to take, you know, different types of technology, you know, as threats evolve, you know, being able to protect the passengers as they're coming into the airport or through a checkpoint, or even those employees and, you know, potentially, you know, mitigating that insider threat as well. So a lot of different applications. And I think Toronto is certainly taking advantage of the opportunity there.
So as you mentioned, you've been beta testing for a few months now. So what's sort of the next stages here? Give me sort of an idea of the next 6 to 12 months, what's coming up for the company.
Yeah, so, you know, we're on target for, well, first of all, we'll complete kind of our beta process kind of through the end of this year. And then we're on target for, you know, Q1 production, you know, first, you know, low rate production of the HEXWAVE technology. And then we'll look to, you know, put it out into the field in Q2 of 2023. You know, for those early adopters and really for the commercial marketplace. And, you know, again, we're seeing a lot of demand in a lot of different market verticals.
And that was my last question for you was, you mentioned that what we've seen around, you know, the US, but also around the world as well, there are threats everywhere. Are you getting calls on a regular basis and the interest really growing in for this type of technology?
Yeah, we are. And it, you know, it ranges, you know, from anywhere we're really where people are gathering, you know, whether it's, you know, we have the capability through our FCC waiver to work indoors and outdoors. So we're starting to see, you know, concert venues, sporting events that happen, you know, casinos, hotels, you know, courthouses. It's really been, you know, as I mentioned, you know, some distribution centers. So we're seeing a lot of calls coming in, you know, and again, unfortunately, the threats continue to evolve. So the technology has to try and be one step ahead. And that's really our goal here at Liberty. And you know, we've got a group of engineers that have done this in the past and, you know, have produced technology like this in the field. So we're trying to stay a step ahead.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Bill, thank you so much. Great to catch up with you and appreciate the time.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. Appreciate it.
All right, there's Bill Frain, the CEO of Liberty Defense.